Acquiring a property in LA can be a battle. So watch this video for all the strategies and the three key ingredients and how to help your offer beat the rest. What's up, this is BK in LA. Welcome to my channel where I show you Los Angeles homes and we talk strategies on how to sell and buy said homes. Today we're talking about how to win a bidding war or how to beat out multiple offers. And this can happen right out of the gate with your first offer or late in the rounds. So fair warning, this video is gonna be high level play today. I have other videos for beginners, but I'm gonna assume today not only are you pre-approved, but that you've been out there writing offers and probably writing offer after offer and losing offers, and we wanna change that. Or you're just getting started and you don't wanna learn this three or four offers down the road, you just wanna start winning. But I wanna give you strategies that are gonna make your offer look stronger without upping our offer price. There are two factors that win in Los Angeles real estate: price and speed. Let's think about it. When we say that the market is hot, it's price, and when we say it's competitive, it's about the terms, AKA the speed. Time kills all deals. Sellers want their money, not now, but right now. And to be clear, a fast close is cool, but it's more about the days until we remove our inspection contingency. So an offer with a 20-day contingency period and a 25-day close is less attractive than an offer with a 10-day contingency period and a 30-day close. So first off, let's dispel some rumors. The dreaded cash offer as competition. We do not fear cash offers as competition, and I'll tell you why. The first thing is, professionals, investors, make cash offers, not regular people, end users, as we call them. And the reason this is important is because an end user is probably going to close, or at least be nervous about canceling. A professional, an investor, they don't care. They put offers in all the time, sometimes they even put their deposit in, they cancel, it's no skin off their back. So a good listing agent will know that a cash offer is probably coming from someone that might not really care about canceling. Whereas you, with your hard-fought loan that we got, is going to care and is going to probably close. So fear not the cash offer. So that's the sentiment. To talk technical, the only reason a cash offer is better is because it removes two of the three contingencies. It removes the need for an appraisal and it removes the need for a loan contingency, because it's cash.
All right, so you're ready for the first key ingredient and how we make your offer beat all the rest? The first thing we do is, just like a cash offer, on the paperwork, we're gonna remove the appraisal contingency and we're gonna remove the loan contingency. We're gonna waive them both. So now our offer and a cash offer are both down to one contingency left. We each have the inspection contingency left. We are tied on the contingency front.
But Brent, what if the appraisal comes in low or the loan doesn't get funded? Are we not still protected? Of course you're protected. I would never leave you unprotected. But the way we're protected now is under the shorter but much more powerful and broad buyer's inspection contingency period. So the reality is, instead of writing an offer with a 15-day appraisal and a 17-day loan period, we write it with just a 10-day inspection period. And yes, we have to work faster to get the same amount of work done. So to be clear, we still do the appraisal and we still do the loan due diligence. We literally still send an appraisal out there, and the listing agent will have to let them in. I mean, they know we're getting a loan, it's on the offer, it just says that we waived that contingency. But if we still wanna let an appraiser in there for our own buyer's due diligence, buyer inspection, we absolutely are granted access to let an appraiser in to see what's up with that property. This may seem like an obvious strategy, but it's a high level play and everybody on the team needs to be in sync all the way through, or it can be very stressful. Let's remember, it's your 3% deposit that's on the line here. But here's the golden ticket, here's the MacGuffin. Here's how we get this done while still providing protection for the buyer.
All right, you ready for the second and third ingredient and how we help your offer beat the rest? The second is you. The third is a rockstar lender. So what I mean by this is, you, the buyer, need to get your financial documents all in order. We need to take that file and bring it to the lender. The lender will then start prepping the loan before we find the property. That's the key.
The reason this can be difficult, quite honestly, is because a lot of buyers will tell their agent, "Let's go shopping, and when I find a property, then I'll drag my ass to the broker and do the boring paperwork." No, that's not it. You have to do your homework now, and then we can come to the plate swinging, because that's your competition. The people that you're up against, they're ready to go. They're locked, they're loaded, and they are ready to go. So why else are we not intimidated by cash offers? Because a lot of times cash offers digress into hard money loans. Nothing in real estate is written in stone, only ink, and a buyer can change their method of payment if the seller's okay with it. A hard money loan has a higher interest rate but less hoops to jump through, so probably attainable. But still some strings attached, and a good listing agent might see this coming and advise a seller against it. Bottom line here, while cash offers sound good, to a skilled agent, there'll be a red flag that the buyer is a professional who has no problem dangling a shiny offer and then canceling.
Furthermore, we're not even gonna be intimidated by non-contingent offers, because typically an all-cash non-contingent offer is gonna be low. So you don't have to offer more money, you just have to offer a regular amount. And your contingencies and terms are already skinnied up super fast. So a seller will wait a little extra time to get all their money, assuming that they think that you'll close, which they probably will favor you closing, an end user, over a professional. And lastly, and this is not common knowledge and I cannot stress it enough, a non-contingent all-cash offer can still screw over the seller. If they do not give their deposit within 3 days and they cancel on the fifth day, there's nothing to go after them for. If they don't give a deposit into escrow, it's very hard to chase down that money. So a non-contingent all-cash offer is not a lock. So keep these things in mind. And if you like a property, keep going after it.
And what if we're not up against a cash low offer? What if the other offer price is high? You're gonna offer as much as you feel comfortable offering. So if the competition is an end user, they're probably going slower than us. Maybe not slow enough to matter, but they're probably rolling with all three contingencies still in place, where you're rolling with one, and that does matter. We are not necessarily getting a deal here, we are in a bidding war. And the goal is likely to buy a property and make it a home and get in on a market that seemingly is going up and up over the course of time. So that being said, the real point of this strategy is to leave only price being the way that you can lose. If you offer as much as you feel comfortable offering and implement this strategy, then no matter what happens, you've left it all on the table. So no matter what the other offers are doing, you're not necessarily competing with them as much as trying to put together an offer that the seller would like to accept. And imagine you're the seller now, and the buyer's coming at you with two of three contingencies already removed. You're probably gonna say, that buyer is serious, they're gonna move quickly, I get a good feeling from them. Okay, a lot of information, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, put them in the comments, or send me an email, or a text, or even a phone call, no problem. If you wanna see more property tours, check out this batch of videos. If you wanna talk more strategies, such as what's an initial deposit, more about escrow, and more about what the contingencies are, check out over here. See you next time.